Okay, so now we move on to study types of model organisms. So which model organisms are commonly used in the study of biology? Now, although there are many model organisms which are used in the field of biology, but we will talk about 7 most widely used model organisms, its advantages and its uses. So let's talk about first E. coli. Now, E. coli is a bacteria which is small and unicellular. It has also rapid reproduction rate and it grows rapidly in simple nutrient broth. The reproduction rate is very rapid. It divides approximately after 20 minutes. So it can be used to study DNA replication, transcription and translation. However, E. coli is evolutionarily very distinct to humans. But because this replication, transcription and translation process are so much conserved, we can use E. coli to study all these processes. The second organism is Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Saccharomyces cerevisiae is the common yeast which we use to brew beer and also for baking of bread. Now, Saccharomyces cerevisiae is a yeast which is eukaryotic, so it is advantageous over bacteria E. coli, which is prokaryotic. It is also unicellular and has rapid reproduction rate like E. coli. It is used to study mainly cell cycle, and also there are other uses also. Now, the third model organism which is commonly used is Arabidopsis thaliana. Arabidopsis thaliana is a small weed plant which is used as a model plant. However, although it is a plant, but it is evolutionary closer to humans compared to both these single cell organisms. So it is used, mainly it is used to study the development and physiology of plants. Now we move on to our fourth model organism, that is Drosophila melanogaster. Drosophila melanogaster, the common name for it is fruit fly. It is extensively used in the classical genetics from past years to study chromosome and genes and to study the structure of chromosomes basically. Nowadays also it is also used in developmental study of developmental biology. Then we move on to C. elegans. Now C. elegans or Cynalodoptis elegans is a worm which has exact 959 cells in the body. So it is very useful to study developmental biology because it has exact 959 cells in the body. It has also led to understanding of apoptosis. Now apoptosis, the understanding of apoptosis is very important for the cancer research. So, and it is also used in the developmental biology. Now the second last model organism is zebrafish. So zebrafish is a fish which is transparent for the first 2 weeks of its life cycle. So it is transparent and so we can directly see the developing embryo. So it is extensively used in the study of developmental biology. However, it has its flaws. So then the last model organism which is most widely used and extensively used is mice. Mice is a mammal, so it is very close to humans, and it is possible to remove specific genes from the mice. So after removal of specific genes, we can know its function. So it is used to identify human genes involved in diseases and also for drug trials. Thank you.